Hi guys, and welcome back to Day Film Photography. Sorry I've not been uploading any videos of late. The reason for that is because I've been away on holiday to the Philippines and I spent 6 weeks out there. The only body I brought with me was my Nikon D750 and a couple of lenses, mainly my Tamron 24-70 and this bad boy, the Tamron 15-30mm. I haven't really used this much before I went, but while I was there, this is the lens that I used mainly on the D750, and I have to say it's just amazing. I went to particularly shoot street photos because in the Philippines, especially in the city, there's so much to see and do. There's opportunities absolutely everywhere you look, and I was so glad I was able to shoot some wide angle shots using this lens. I did get some great shots with the 24-70 as well, but this is the one that I had on the body most of the time. Now, in case you haven't used this lens, I recommend that if you're looking for a wide angle, this is the one to go for. Apparently it even outshines the Nikon variant, the 14-24, and it has VC vibration control for Tamron. It's a 2.8 aperture through old focal lens from 15-30mm. It's a superb lens for portraits, street, landscape, you name it. It's just a fine piece of glass. I've yet to use it at really late at night, although I did use it some in low light situations, and coupled with the 750, it really performed well. So let's have a look at some of the images that I did take, and you can see how this lens performed. Okay, so let's fire up Lightroom. You can see I've already done the import, and some of these shots were taken with the Tamron 24-70, including this one. None of these have been edited yet, so we're just going to have a flick through and see the kind of shots that I did get. This was taken from the third floor in the shopping complex, a shopping mall over there, just to, so you can see what the traffic looks like out there in the Philippines. Like I say, it's not been edited. There might be a few touch-ups because of these lights here in the sky. They're not actually in the sky, they are window reflections because I was inside a shopping mall, as I explained. But I will just give it a little bit of a tweak anyway. Another thing that I would do as well, usually when I first come into a shot, is to enable a profile correction, because sometimes the camera doesn't get it right and it needs to know to straighten the image or to flatten it, so to speak. So you see when I click on this, it comes up. It looks kind of bulbous here in the center without the profile correction, but once you click the profile correction, it flattens out the image. So you can see it says there 24-70, 2.8, da 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 da. Yeah, you can go ahead and make some more adjustments there if you really want to, like adjust the clarity, increase the clarity, reduce the highlights, sort out the temperature if you want, so you can make it a little bit warmer looking outside. You can even go into and straighten it a tiny bit there. So that's that shot. Let's go along to a couple more. It amazes me in that country that these people are allowed to stand at the back of the vehicles. There's no way you'd be allowed to do that here in the UK. Totally illegal, just to holding on to the sewer pipes that are going to install. It's a developing country, so a lot of the sewer works and stuff hasn't been completed yet, but they are working on it, which is quite good. Another shot taken by the train tracks. The reason I like this, and I know it's taken with the 24-70, we'll move on to the 15-30 lens shots in a minute, but just to show you some of the shots that I did take while I was out there. So again, just with this one, enable profile correction, just to give it the perspective it deserves. You can see here, there's clothes hanging out on the washing line. I was actually in the car when the shot was taken, so there is slight motion to the photo. But this shot was taken along the train tracks. This is actually someone's property. They live right next to the train tracks. Some people actually live on the train tracks. You can see down here, this is an actual house. There's a coat hanger there. More people living down here, and a little dog over here walking along. I'm gutted that this photo is a bit blurred. but it's due to the motion in the car because we were crossing the tracks at the time. You can see people sitting here outside their property. Excuse me. Yeah, what an amazing sight. Just some amazing stuff to see. And this is probably someone's house here as well. Incredible. Slightly silhouetted shot there. A dog outside a house, front house. Mountain view. This is actually taken with the Tamron 70-300mm lens zoomed in to capture the landscape there in the background. So moving on, we have some street shots here, again taken with the 24-70. Another one, and a street fender there, again, same lens. So moving on, oh yeah, this is one of my favourite shots. This was taken with the 24-70, and I shot this blind. I know it's a bit dark. Let's just pop this one up a little bit and increase the exposure just so you can see. This is a little stray kitten that approached me in the street. One of my most favourite shots that I did take while I was out there. So I'm just going to increase some of the features on this shot, like the clarity and stuff like that as well. I will crop this tiny little bit as well, just to bring the cat into perspective there. Bring it down a little bit, so he's slightly off centre. Yeah, have a look at that. Look at that face. See the dirt in his whiskers, really dirty face. Basically I put the lens and the camera down on the floor and I shot this blind so I couldn't see through the viewfinder while I took the shot. But I'm really happy with the focus on his face and his eyes. It's one of my most favourite pictures that I did take while I was in the Philippines. It's quite a character he's got on his face there. Really, really nice shot. I'm really happy with that. So moving on, you can see some of the ones here. So now we're going into the 15 to 30 territory, so it's a 15 millimeter. Again, let's go down, enable profile corrections. There you go, as you can see, it's kind of popped there a little bit, slightly overexposed. So what I'm going to do is just reduce the highlights on that one a slight touch and bring the exposure down, not that much, maybe minus 0.36, that will do. I'm not really sure if you can straighten that. I wonder if I go down here and go into basic and see if I can level it or put it on vertical and see what happens. Hopefully it'll level. Okay, that's what level does. Kind of adds a different perspective to the church, but it is straight in terms of looking direct into the church there, so that's not bad. I think I'll keep it like that. Yeah, this is a 300-year-old building. Absolutely amazing. Even the inside was incredible. And that was shot with the 15 to 30. Again, another shot, slightly different perspective, trying to remove the car here. Just let Lightroom sort that one out. And again, I wonder if I go for a level on this one, what'll happen? See if it'll level it a little bit. Not that much of a difference, but it's kind of cropping the door out there, so I wonder if I should just undo that. And if you zoom right in, just this retain the features. Okay, you can see some noise there. This is because it was an ISO 3200, but I'm not bothered. Still a great shot. This is the door, is the original door that was on the building, and it's actually broken here, so somebody sits inside the door to keep an eye on the place. But look at that incredible stonework. What amazes me as well, that nearly every place in the Philippines, they have bars on the windows. Well, these look wooden. I'm assuming that they're actually metal to make it look wood. Everywhere is protected by these bars to stop potential burglars breaking in. So moving on again, 15mm, a market scene. Obviously a lot of the shots that I did take need adjusting in terms of the exposure and stuff like that. Because of the light changing conditions, I didn't have time to adjust. Maybe only the ISO on here, so I kept it at 200. This is shot at f8 just to fit more of the product in. Again, what I'm going to do is just increase the shadows here. and then reduce the highlights in the background, brings out more of the image, gives a bit more drama, increase the clarity of touch. And just have a look, this is again was shot from the hip, so there's a bit of motion. Actually there's a lot of motion, but it's not too bad from a distance. Another one, this was inside the building, so again a few adjustments have been made. Again, ISO 3200 on this one at 21mm, still using the 15-30 lens. If I just click on the exposure, I can bring up the touch. There you go. Reduce that. This is a dry fish market, so if you have a look here. These are all dry fish. Now you can see there's noise there, so what I'm going to do is just, because I like this image, just reduce a bit of the noise there. I'm just going to go down, enable profile correction. And see, we can go into the noise reduction, so it's down here. Just to reduce some of the noise, see what happens with that. It's taking a bit of time for Lightroom to work on the image. There you go, yeah, it's worked a little bit. So, yeah, I like this shot. Loads of dry fish. Another one here. It amazes me as well, in that country, how everyone's got technology. Well, that's pretty much everyone. I'd say a lot of the kids don't have any. So just increase the, all I'm going to do is just increase the shadows on this one a touch. You can see this lady's got an iPad while she's waiting for some customers to buy some of her dried fish. But yeah, this is, I wouldn't have got this without this such a wide angle, so you can see the variety of food that she's got on display here. Me not being a fish lover, I didn't even ask what some of it was. I think some of it's seaweed, and then a lot of it's just dried fish. Again, because in this island is called Bolinau, it's a main fishing village, and that's pretty much what they live on. A couple of ladies sitting outside. There's a guy there. This is actually a 30mm, so I'd have zoomed in at this point. Just moving along. This lady's washing her clothes while she's outside. A lot of kids hanging around. I like this one because of the little baby just clinging onto mummy. Again, a slight motion in this shot. This one was shot at 140 though a second from the hip. So, and it's only ISO 71. And then we've got this young child. Again, hip shot. This one's slightly underexposed, so what I'll do is just increase the exposure on that one. I could straighten it if I wanted to. I'm probably not going to, because if I do, what'll happen, if I move it too much, straighten it too much, I'm going to lose the girl's feet. Whoops. So, if I want to straighten the horizon at the background, I'm going to lose the girl's feet slightly, although I can probably get away with that and then have her hand cropped a little bit instead and just remove that kid down the bottom there. And that's quite a nice shot. These are one of the street kids. But it amazes me how happy these children are, even though they've got nothing. You know, they have very little. But they're amazing nonetheless. They just get along with what they have got. You don't see them running around chasing Pokemon on their mobile phones. You know, with a little stick-on tattoo. Feet covered with sand. Amazing. But such characters the kids have. So I could increase the clarity on this one just to give it a bit more drama. But I don't want to go too much to make it look HDR. And then what will happen, you'll get ghosting around the girl as well, so I don't really want that. So you can just increase the contrast there a little bit as well, just to give it slight more drama. There's another shot of her here. I like this one a little bit better because she's, looks like she's got the wind blowing her hair. It's quite a nice photo actually, I like this one. It's Got a really nice expression on her little face, bless her. Probably only about five years old, not really sure. Again, because the horizon's slightly crooked in the background, if I try and straighten it, I'm definitely going to lose more of her feet on this one, which I don't really want to do. But then again, I could just bring the drama close to her, closer, have her closer in the frame, so. Crop her there, that's probably not too bad. There you go. You're more drawn to her expression now, I guess. But yeah, really nice shot. Let's just reduce the highlights there a little bit. Lovely. Increase the clarity touch. There you go. Really like that shot. Cute little child, look. Happy. Happy as anything with the very little they've got. Moving on. Lovely little boy. Surrounded by the washing. It makes me laugh, the washing hanging up here. Hanging over the sea. Again, just increase that touch, not too much because of the. Just increase the blacks there and exposure a touch more. He's actually looking at my friend. It's not very clear either, which is a shame. But photos don't always have to be pin sharp. It depends on the distance they are taken, and I probably wouldn't use this shot anyway, I'm not really sure, but I still like it anyway. Moving on, again this is at 30mm, okay, I can see a few dust spots here on the shot, so I'm just going to remove those while I'm here in Lightroom. I had to clear the lens a little bit, look, more down here, and another one just here. Quite nice. Probably increase the shadows on this one a bit, and with this one definitely increase the clarity a little bit, and maybe the exposure a touch. This is why we were on a boat traveling actually into the island itself. You can see it's covered in palm trees and some of these little fishing vessels that the locals use to go fishing. A little house nestled in the coastline there. Loads of palm trees filled with coconuts. You can actually see some on this tree here. So that might be worth going through and fixing the profile correction on there. And then these were taken at the pier. Look at the size of that dragonfly. Massive. And these are some of the local kids that came along once they saw us. You don't get many Filipino kids that have seen many tourists, so these guys were happy to follow us. They were laughing and joking with us. You can see they don't have much. Not one of them came with a phone. They all came with just enthusiasm and happiness and followed us to the pier. This is where I asked them, are you going to jump into the sea? And they were like, no. And then before you know it, they start jumping in, clothes and all. So I really like this shot, and it's actually done quite well on some of the online websites where I've posted it, and I've actually received an award for this photo already. What I did do to it, even though it's unedited here, I did actually touch it up a little bit, and I'll show you what I did do to the image. I kind of warmed it up a little bit, and I dropped the shadows down a touch because I just wanted to keep the outline on this little chubby kid here and have this kid more of a silhouette. So I just dropped the blacks down a bit, and there you go, kind of kept it like that. And I posted it online, yeah, and it's done really well. It just needs a bit of a clean up on here. These are all been pre-edited before. I just thought I'd bring you in and show you some of the raw files that I've captured. So this is straight out of the camera pretty much, not now because I've edited it, but yeah, using that 15-30mm lens, it's been amazing. And again, the same shot, actually, that is this, that is the original shot, and this is the edited version. So going through more, Mr. Chubby Kid on his way in, and again all three of them jumping. I like this one as well because of the sunburst. What I would have done with this one is actually keep the shadows down and just increase the sun, so it looks a bit more dramatic. It's really nice. And once again, enable profile correction, just to pop it a little bit, and then sort out these lens spots on here. Quite a few that are very noticeable on here. And probably quicker to do this kind of thing in Photoshop. Lightroom I mainly use just for the light adjustments and increasing or reducing the contrast and the shadows and stuff like that. Most of the extra processing I would bring it into Photoshop and sort it out there. But I like this shot as well. I wonder if I just straighten the horizon, will that make it a little bit better? There you go, not too bad. You can increase the whites on it there a bit if you want. And then that's gonna reduce the sun, see? When you reduce the highlights, it drops the sun behind the image. It's better to have it like that, I guess. You could go and increase the vibrance, but I'm happy the way it is or the saturation. Ooh, it's a bit too orange. So that's, for me, that's a great shot. And again, and you've got some local fishermen and the little kid swimming here. It's cool how it just life carries on. These are dragonflies, so I'm not going to bother editing those out. Let's go along, have a look at a few more. There's the boat on its own. That's the pier from the other side. On the way back then from the pier, we came across this guy and his friends here in this little hut. This guy was keen to come and show me his tattoos. He hasn't got the best body in the world. In fact, he looks a bit like he's hungry a bit. But he didn't care about food. He asked me if I had some wine to give him. Sadly, I was wearing my shorts and t-shirt, and I don't really carry wine on a regular basis with me, so I had to decline his request, sadly. But he's a character nonetheless. Some of the people out there really amaze me. The fact they've got nothing, but they're so happy in themselves, just makes me so humbled. But yeah, going along, then we have this scene that I shot that's using the 24-70, actually, this one. And again, that's 24-70 as well. But this shot here was at 15mm. This is the place we were staying in on the island, which is really, really nice. What I would do with this one is to enable profile correction and probably just straighten it a touch, maybe. Just that way. This stick you see sticking out here, along here, this is a coconut tree. So I don't know if you zoom in, you can see some coconut. There you go, some coconuts here in the tree. These are, in England we get the brown coconuts. That's what's inside these green shells. So during the summer season and rainy season, these coconuts are ready now. So you can chop them out of the tree. They use this bamboo stick to cut them down out of the tree. And when they fall, they open the coconut for you and you can drink the juice out of it, and it's absolutely delicious. Buko juice, they call it over there. Coconut water. And when you see the price of coconut water in the supermarkets here in the UK, it's for a small carton of it, it's like £1.80, nearly £2. And over there it's grown in abundance and in the trees, and it's free. So it's a, and it's more delicious, it hasn't been processed, it's fresh, straight as it is. You just have to cut the coconut open and it's all yours. So for this one, I'll probably bring this into a HDR program and give it some drama in the sky. I can see it's like lens dust on there, but yeah, I'll definitely give it a bit more clarity. It's not really possible to do in here to give it a HDR tone. But that's what I'll probably do once I take it into Lightroom, so I'll just increase the shadows there a little bit, drop the blacks back a little bit, exposure, okay, I guess at the moment the highlights I'll bring down so you can see more drama in the sky. So yeah, that's definitely one worth taking in and giving a slight HDR treatment in Photoshop. So there you go, that's some of the shots that I did take with the Nikon D750 and the Tamron 15-30mm f/2.8. So I hope you like some of the shots that I've taken, and I hope you like what the Tamron is capable of. It's a really great bit of glass. If I was you, go and do your price comparison, you'll see it's a hell of a lot cheaper than the Nikon variant, and it performs just as well, if not slightly better. It's dead sharp in the center and at the edges too. Great bit of glass, and it's absolutely lovely to use. So thanks for watching my video. If you like what you see and you like what I do, please smash the subscribe button. It's down there somewhere. Give us a thumbs up if you like my videos, and I'll see you back again the next time. Thanks very much for watching. Take care.